it right here. And then it also made a nice little dent in the back of that. Found one. This one came out keyholed and then it bounced on the ground. So it didn't mushroom out while it must have started tumbling. But there is one that didn't pass all the way through. Almost did. That mushroomed pretty well. That's beautiful. I'm shooting from over there. The Neilson 235 hollow point. Wow. Look at that wound cavity. That's huge. The exit. He had a bad day. I just want to see at, what's that, 3,800 or so PSI, how far we can get through this that way. And I'm not going to be like almost 50 yards away this time, I'll be pretty close, like 10 or 15 yards away. Check out how weird this is. That's the shot we just did. That's where it laid. So pretty far up. But I heard the table smack. You couldn't really hear it on slow-mo. And this is just right on the edge. But there's nothing on the table. No marks, no nothing. So I'm going to shoot a variety of different regular pellets through the AEA Challenger at this thing the long way, because it's fun. I can see the Hades, but it's hard to find. Right there. It's in there. So it's really hard to see, but it's right next to the Hades. See it. Okay, you can kind of get a little look at them right there. They're like touching. There you go. on the other side so we can actually see it. Put it right here so we can see it. Nice big entrance. I mean, that one flattened out really well too. That one's as flat as a pancake. 3,000 PSI, 10 yards. Why not try a little TR50 action on this thing? Bang, bang. These are the rubber balls with iron inside or metal inside. Marked it up. That would not feel good. Those are the rubber metal balls. These are the nylon balls now. Look at that eye shot. That's the nylon ball.